sé que producen mujeres en las comunidades y nosotras que tenemos la oportunidad de estar también aquí compartiendo con ustedes nuestro quehacer.
So she's very thankful for, to be here again in Madison, and she was thinking about the how they ended up here and the whole process that they've gone to come here. And so it began as through their participation in the women's movement. I'm not sure who it was, but someone invited them here several years ago. And so through this process of the last 10 years since they became organized in 95, they've met a number of different people and different organizations. So they were connected with WCCN. WCCN introduced them to us, to Just Coffee, and so it's moved forward, and now we're back here again.
Somos una organización pequeña, pero con mucho ánimo de querer impulsar procesos de cambio. La Fundación Entre Mujeres, con sus programas, tiene una cobertura de unas 3,000 mujeres. Está llegando pues a unas 3,000 mujeres rurales, sobre todo con el programa de empoderamiento ideológico. Y en la parte de empoderamiento económico están participando unas 600 mujeres que están trabajando por su seguridad alimentaria, su soberanía alimentaria, y que tienen un pequeño excedente ya para visibilizarse en el mercado local, ¿verdad? Porque todos estos productos que la Irma presentaba se están vendiendo en el mercado local y nacional, y el café que se está exportando aquí a Estados Unidos.
We are a very small organization, but we have a lot of energy and desire to promote these social processes of social change. So we reach 3,000 rural women in Nicaragua, and mostly focusing on ideological empowerment. And there are 600 women who are reached through our economic empowerment programs, which mainly focus on food security, which is programs with organic vegetable gardens or rice and bean production, which is for their own consumption as well as to sell locally in their markets, as well as coffee production, which we have here that's exported and sold locally. But all of this is working towards making ourselves more visible locally as well as internationally.
So, I don't know if people have questions or comments.
I guess I have a question. In Nicaragua, how much sales are there in Nicaragua? Because I know in the rural community they use instant coffee, and I mean we here use we can grind coffee. But I'm just curious how much volume is actually occurs within Nicaragua, and do they make instant coffee?
¿Cómo es el café que se vende en el mercado local? O sea, ¿cuál porcentaje del café se vende localmente y toman café como un café o cómo es la cultura del café y cuánto venden localmente?
Bueno, el café que se vende en el mercado local es el café que clasifica o que no clasifica para la exportación. Es el café que no reúne pues las características adecuadas para poder exportarse. Es un café de calidad, pero que no reúne el tamaño, ¿verdad?, de las demandas del cliente aquí, o que son granos quebrados. Ese es el café que nosotras estamos procesando allá y comercializando en el mercado local. Es digamos como un tal vez un 10% de la producción.
So the coffee that is sold locally is about 10% of all the coffee that they produce. And it's, so when the coffee, as we saw in the it's called the Beneficio, the dry mill, when it's processed there, that's where it's exported. So it's classified between first grade quality, second grade, and third grade. And all of the first grade quality is exported. So that's what they receive because you can get a higher price for it. And the second grade quality might have some minor defects. It's still good quality, but not as good to meet the demands requirements of the international market. And so it's about 10%, and that's what is sold locally.
No podemos competir con las grandes empresas que producen café, que lo que menos tiene es café. Pero sí, nuestro mercado es selectivo.
So we can't compete with the big transnational companies. companies that sell like the instant coffee, which is not even made up of that much coffee.
consume nuestro café, gente que ya va desarrollando conciencia sobre el consumo consciente y que quieren pues de así como aquí colaborar con los procesos de empoderamiento que están llevando las mujeres en las comunidades.
So the people that are consuming our coffee locally are people who are kind of aware, they're conscious consumers, same as people here, the reason that they're consuming our coffee, that understand the bigger meaning and that are contributing to the economic empowerment of these women.
Yeah, this is actually a question for, you're the executive director, correct?
Mm-hmm.
I think it's fantastic what WCCN does. I studied public affairs and public management, and unfortunately read a lot about how microfinance doesn't work in different parts of the world, or people, there's disincentive to continue providing the services and the ability to make it continue working. How is WCCN in particular held accountable or how are they transparent? How does that particular organization work? Do you think, and maybe it would be in other areas
of
the world?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Well, first of all, I will say that WCCN has been working on microfinance the beginning of our work with microfinance was as a tool for development.
Mm-hmm.
And we started doing that 20 years ago when we were approached by a group of churches in Nicaragua that they wanted us to create the first microfinance institution there.
Mm-hmm.
So it was out of a need for credit that the organization started. But the WCCN was had been funded 6 years before that, when we started working with credit. So that to say that that we were very aware of the difficulties of any kind of development work.
Right.
So a big difference with, and we think that a big difference with other organizations working on microfinance that were created later, especially in the last, say, 10 years, that are true believers of microfinance as the only and the main tool for development. So we believe that we always believe and still believe that microfinance is a very important tool for development, but it's not the only one. And we always try to work with groups that. Originally we only worked in Nicaragua for many years, and the last 3 years we started. Diversifying and expanding to other countries, and we always try to work with groups that work on credit, but also that have other kind of services. So that is the importance of working with the credit unions, like Comics Move, where members are really involved in the organization and the decision-making process, or other microfinance institutions that provide other kind of services like health services and that. So that is the way as we write. But I'm not sure we have here other people from my organization. I don't know if anyone would want to add what I said. But I don't know if I answered your question.
Yeah, it sounds to me like your screening process for people that you will lend to is very, I don't want to say screening process, but you make diplomatic decisions. It's not just kind of throwing money out.
We, sorry, go ahead.
I was going to say, I think one of the differences with WCCN is it's much smaller, and because of the way it started, it's much more personal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think, especially as Carlos was saying, the last 10 years, and I might even say 5, I forget when they started talking about it, but you know, not that many years ago, even though microfinance had been around for a while, there was this massive rush of capital. right, in the tens of millions of dollars, because people had decided it was the answer. But I think a lot of the organizations did it in a way that was sort of, you know, based only on balance sheets, and, you know, they were new to the business, they were new to all the partners, they worked in a ton of different countries, you know, a lot of these, they're, and so in that case, it didn't work that well.
Yeah.
Because it's not that straightforward. It's not that easy to make it work as we see in Nicaragua. Sort of things that happen globally and nationally can make it fall apart pretty quickly, you know? And so I think that's one of the reasons that WCCN does work, is because it has been so small. For, you know, we've been working with the same people for a long time, and some of the organizations around the world number, I'm like, if I think I'm 17, you know, these are 3 years old. So it's like really long relationships. We have staff that are, for a long time, it was only Nicaragua, so, you know, we had someone there who had contacts everywhere, and I think that's why it can work, you know, and I'm
more personal.
It is, and then you can also be more careful, you know, and you can weigh things, and you can react a little bit better, and you're also not trying to do things $50 million at a time, which is really, it's easier and harder, you know, but it's, I think that's what happened, is all of a sudden someone thought, what a great idea, I'm going to put $100 million in microfinance worldwide.
Right.
Well, good luck.
Yeah.
And, you know, a lot of those organizations 5 years later said, you know what, actually, I don't want to do that after all. And they take all that money back, but that's also really damaging.
Yeah.
I mean, that's really hard on the organization.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay, thank you very much, everyone, for attending.
Thank you.
Thank you. If you want to learn more about WCCN or the organizations, you can check our website. If you want to support and buy coffee from La Femme, you can find it locally through Just Coffee. As we saw in the video, you can find it at the Willie Street Pub. What else? All over Madison.
Yeah, I can't believe I did it all those. At the Discovery Center. And several different cafes around the square, different restaurants around town.
Check this, yes.
Thank you. Excelente, Irma.
Yeah.
Muy bien.